right now on Money Matters Today. The holiday spending season is over. Black Friday is long gone. But are you in the red from overspending this holiday season? We've got some creative ways to better your financial picture that won't cost you a dime. The answers to your holiday debt could be as simple as grabbing a pen and paper. Our experts break down the art of budgeting and help you get back on track in the new year with your finances. Money Matters Today starts right now. Personal finance, saving, investing. It's your money. This is CNA Money Matters Today. And now, host Mary Caracoli.
Welcome to CNA Money Matters Today, getting your money back on track after the holidays. We will show you strategies for paying off debt and building wealth in the new year. Changing a few habits today will pay dividends throughout the year.
Let the money hangover begin.
We are working to get your money back on track in the new year, and one of the best ways to do that is to get organized. And yes, the B word, budget. Now stick with us for the next 5 or so minutes, and we will show you how to get a real budget working for you today. Helping us to do that is Judy Lawrence. She is the author of The Budget Kit, a money management workbook. Judy joins us from San Francisco. Welcome and Happy New Year, Judy.
Happy New Year, Mary.
So the B word, we're going to say right off the bat, people hate the word budget, but we're going to show them how to do it so that it will help them build wealth in the new year. First of all, you say you really need to take a look at what you want and state some clear goals, and you say state very specific goals. Why is that?
You want to state very specific goals so that you're motivated. And I think it's also very important that you really have a specific reason that you're going to change some behavior, change your attitude, and be motivated to start a budget. We can call it a spending plan or whatever it is, but really think of it as taking control and owning your own power in this process instead of seeing it as deprivation.
And of course you say use a system. We just saw four ideas up there for that system. You say plan, track, review, and readjust. Now let's talk about the plan, number one up there, first of all, creating that spending plan. What should we be looking at very specifically if we're going to do this?
Very specifically, the plan is the most critical piece. This is where you're being proactive and you're anticipating. I actually encourage people to start with a plan in terms of the yearly budget worksheet, meaning those periodic expenses. Thinking about the real estate taxes, your insurances, your car maintenance, tuition for children's school, those occasional expenses that show up periodically, quarterly, semi-annually, annually. A lot of people overlook this, and this is a huge missing link for your planning. So that's one place to plan. A second planning piece is then your month. You know, you already talked about planning on paying off the credit card debt. Well, first of all, you want to plan by thinking about all your fixed expenses and outlining your fixed expenses. Think about the variable expenses, and I think we'll have a chart showing all of that.
Yeah.
But this is all part of your planning ahead for the month. Thinking through thoroughly, what are all my expenses going to be for this upcoming month?
And that's so important that you have both of those plans, because the monthly one is, you're right, what we always think about. We always think about in our budget the mortgage or rent, the car payment, and those things that we write the check every month, the utilities and so forth. But it is those occasional expenses that really come back and bite us because we don't have the money saved for them.
And that's the area that is really important to think about. And most people don't think ahead in terms of how much will I spend on those lattes? How much will I spend on dry cleaning or entertainment? How many movies? How much will I spend on popcorn going to the movies? How much will I spend on CDs or office supplies for my home, for my printer? The cartridge went out. All of those things. It's very important to think it through, again, being proactive and outlining an entire realistic, comprehensive picture for the month ahead of time, and then comparing it to how much is coming in, how much do I actually have that I need to cover all these expenses, and how much of that am I going to be able to cover the credit card debt, because you really want to put as much on that credit card payment as you can.
Absolutely. And now we've come to the point, if we've done what you've said, and you got that through in 2 minutes, so it's thing folks should be able to do today and get started. So I've done this now, and I've decided by looking at these numbers that I need to cut my spending because I am spending more than I have, more than I'm earning. What are some things I can do today and start to think about today to change that in the months ahead?
And it's important to realize you always have control over this, so this is not about budgeting and deprivation. So you realize I need to cut back. So what are my choices with each of those line items in your budget? One, you get to choose to cut back. Maybe instead of spending, you know, $20 a week on your latte, you spend $10 on your latte. You also get to choose to postpone. Instead of buying that new cell phone this month, you decide, I'll put it off for 2 months. You also have another choice where you can decide, let's be creative. How can I be creative with my spending? Maybe I could barter with someone. Maybe I could trade books and CDs with someone else. Being creative where you're getting your needs met, but not necessarily having to put it off altogether. And then the fourth choice is always the choice to just eliminate it altogether. You know, we do have those choices. And so it's important to review all of our expenses in a way of what can I do to make sure I can manage all this money and manage what I don't have, cut so that I have enough to cover everything.
And I love the operative word there, the empowering word there, is choice. You're not saying mm-hmm. you have to do any of these. It becomes
right.
our choice. We really become our own best advocate for creating wealth in our lives.
Absolutely.
Now, one of the things I like about the budget kit is it. If you want to do this, you have forms made up for folks already. There are a lot of mm-hmm. computer programs out there, and they're not for everyone. They can be, just the data entry alone sometimes can be very overwhelming. And sometimes it's really nice just to be able to see it in black and white with the pencil, with the eraser, and do it the old-fashioned way. I'm sure you get pretty decent feedback about that.
I get tremendous feedback about this because in every household you'll find one person likes to do it online or they like to do it on their software. Another person likes to just tangibly have it in front of them. They want their pencil, they want their paper, they want their calculator and their eraser, and they want to be able to have a better sense of how does this all look. They want the big picture in front of them instead of entering a number that goes into a field and then just disappears. This way you have everything at a glance. And I designed the budget kit to help people who were too busy and didn't have time to create something themselves. And it's also for people who don't know how to get organized, and it helps them organize the whole picture. How do I look at the whole year? How do I look at each month? How do I then actually go to the second step? We talked about planning, but the second step is tracking. How do I track where does my money go so that I can really see the bigger picture and see what I'm actually doing and not be fooling myself? And I have
and
found many times.
And allows you then to bring in that creativity of choosing whether you're going to cut back, mm-hmm. postpone, be creative, and so forth. That when you have that in front of you, that allows you to be creative, change some numbers, and really do your own brainstorming session there, where you can, as you said, it's important to track what you've done. And month after month, this is the time to also then reassess what you've done. This budget isn't mm-hmm. something, a static piece of paper that you file away. It should be an organic thing.
It's very organic, and people who have started doing this, they swear that once they started tracking their spending, they started spending much less, saving much more, and their lifestyle really did not change dramatically at all. And it became a very, as you said, organic process. Every month it's different, and that's why I encourage people not to come up with just an average number for a budget, because then they're wondering what's missing. And what's missing is that each month has its variations. And by tracking, you're going to get to see what your lifestyle is like. You get to see what are your priorities, where do things change each month, and it helps you, again, be in charge of that whole process.
All right, Judy, don't go away, because we're going to be back after these messages with more tips on getting your money back on track. To get your money back on track for the new year, here to offer advice is Judy Lawrence. She is the author of The Budget Kit, a money management workbook. Worst habit you'd like to see people change in the new year?
Worst habit would be to not have any kind of a plan and keep up. They operate on automatic pilot. I want people to stay very conscious and start noticing what they're spending, where they're spending, why they're spending, and start changing those habits.
I love it. And it really does mean, Patty, bringing the family in. Sit around and do the new budget together, too. It always pays to have the kids be part of that budget process, doesn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I did want to encourage that as well. The other thing to keep in mind is, as parents, we really are being role models for the children. So everything they see you do and say is very important for them. And they're very creative. If you bring them process, they have some great ideas.
Mm-hmm. All
so
right.
Definitely.
Good advice, Judy Lawrence. The book is The Budget Kit. And as we found, it's a game for the whole family to play.